Asta's husband tells News 9 that for his family, the Challenger accident will always feel like an event that occurred just recently. And he appreciates the strong community support that he and his children have received over the years. In Concord, a school now bears Krista's name, and the McAuliffe Shepherd Discovery Center welcomes children every day. But what you may not know is that Krista and her flight crew also continue to inspire kids to reach for the stars at learning centers all over the country and the world.
Let's go to 60 and see what it does.
They're traveling to the International Space Station and conducting experiments at a new high-tech facility in San Antonio, Texas.
You have all of your station letters on the left side.
In Framingham, Mass, where teacher Krista McAuliffe attended college, students are working together as a team on a mission to Mars.
It's so cool, honestly. I love it so much.
These highly interactive space adventures are the creation of Challenger Center, a nonprofit organization formed by the families of the Challenger crew in the days after the tragedy.
People who really cared, people who believed in them, wanted to continue that mission.
June Scobie Rogers was married to the Challenger shuttle commander, Dick Scobie. She led the families in the effort to start Challenger Center, which aims to carry on the mission of the Teacher in Space program in memory of the flight crew.
A tribute of something they love so much, something they were willing to risk their lives for.
June, who is also a teacher, helped Krista prepare some of the lessons she hoped to do in space.
See the bubbles? The big ones?
I think she's a nation's teacher, and we all respect and admire her courage to fly aboard Challenger.
These centers hope to encourage children to explore and get them engaged in the areas of STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math.
It's better learning here than at school.
Astronaut Mark Kelly is on the Challenger Center board.
The goal is to inspire some of these kids to be scientists, you know, engineers, maybe medical doctors, because we really need that.
30 years after the shuttle tragedy, there are more than 40 Challenger Centers in 27 states and 4 countries, and 20 communities are now vying to be the next on the list.
30 years later, almost 4.5 million children have had the experience of going up into space through our Challenger Center mission and being inspired to achieve more greatness in their life.
Krista's husband says that Krista would be very proud of the Challenger Learning Centers. And tomorrow night on a special New Hampshire Chronicle, Touching the Future, the Challenger Legacy, you'll learn more about how these centers are making a difference. Plus, June's memories of Krista as she trained with her husband.